after months of violence on the streets and uncertainty over his position. Sudan's Prime Minister Abdalla Hamdok announced his resignation on Sunday.
رئيس الوزراء مفسحا المجال لآخر من بنات أو أبناء هذا الوطن المعطاء لاستكمال قيادة وطن العزيز.
Hamdok was sworn in 2019, becoming Sudan's first civilian prime minister. But in October, an army coup saw Hamdok detained by the army, later to be reinstated. His release and pact with the army did not convince protesters that there will be a transition to full democracy. Since then, protests against the army takeover have shown no signs of abating. An army crackdown on demonstrations has resulted in dozens of people killed and hundreds injured. Protest organizers say 2022 will be the year of continued resistance.
We completely condemn powers such as arrest, search and arbitrary arrest. This is the last card used by the ruling council because they fear our freedom. Arrests will never break our resistance committees. They will arrest us, but we will not give up until we achieve civilian rule.
Coup leader General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan said on Saturday that Sudan faced existential threats that could not be ignored.
Individuals with authority, along with the current conflict which has resulted in loss of life, damage to property and disruption, mean we have to arbitrate the voice of reason and agree to dialogue.
Protesters say that the military must play no role in government on the road to free elections.